Greetings and salutations to all you folks out there. We're back for another game with Orbital Potato. Hey, man.
Oh my goodness. This game, I just can't get enough of it recently. It's been top of my priority list. Oh, it's been fantastic.
Yeah, I've seen you posting some extra stuff on your channel over there too. Speaking of Orbital Potato's channel, we're going to be doing another game after this one, which we'll post at the same time. The link for that is going to be in the description. So after this game, if you can't get enough of it, go ahead and hit that button. Check out his channel. He's got some Forge Alliance stuff over there too. Oh. All right. So we're going to be doing a little bit of a bigger map this time. We've done several games over the last couple of weeks, but it's all kind of been on the smaller maps.
And I'm going to be playing as Aeon, which is something that I've never even done before.
Well, like, new faction's always fun, even if it is the space hippies.
Is there actually like a story for Supreme Commander? Is that like a thing?
There is, you know, like, yes. But at the moment, it is being held up by extreme network lag, so who knows what happens in the lore.
Oh, goodness.
Wow. We may who have to rehost this.
It's Roscopo. I'm not even... Or maybe it's me. Is it me?
It is... Freaky Peep, I think.
Freaky Peep.
No, it is Roscoe. It's Roscoe.
This is unplayable. Like, really unplayable.
All right, we'll see if he can straighten it out real quick. I'll just cut this little bit out.
Oh, shit.
Let's see. All right, we're back. It looks like it's running cleanly. So apparently Roscoe was able to get... Ah, he was downloading. Tut tut. See, this is what you don't do to other people who are kind enough to join you for a game. You don't start a game with all of your downloads.
Oh man, that's just not good enough. You know, you got to prioritize these things, don't you? I mean, craziness, absolute craziness.
All anyway,
right. So you did a little briefing for me before we begun the game, and you were like, okay, Orbital Potato, you need to go for the middle. There's a butt and a mast in the middle. And yeah, I think I'm just going to do that.
A butt ton of mass is putting it very mildly. There is a ludicrous...
Oh my goodness.
Ginormous pile of mass right out here in the center. I mean, there are T3 transports, T3 units, T2 units. Just a scattering thousands of mass.
Gosh darn beautiful.
So basically, the goal at the beginning is going to build... more power than you have ever built in your entire life before and try to burn off as much mass as you possibly can so that you don't waste any.
Oh, dude, I'm working on this. I'm working on this hard. Okay, and after that, we want some power generators.
This is going to be an ultimate exercise in selfishness because basically, even if you can't use all the mass, you want to reclaim it anyway so they can't have it. It's kind of like the whole thing if you have a little sibling. It's like, if I can't have it, nobody can.
The ultimate exercise in selfishness. Wow. Oh, Brink of Insanity 2015. Jeez.
Am I wrong?
You're not wrong. That was just a really, really great way of putting it. Oh, man. All right, correct me.
Well, that pretty much sums up team games in general, honestly.
Oh, that was good. It wasn't even particularly that funny. It was just, you know, sometimes you have one of these moments. It's like, yeah, you know, right time, right place. That's really funny. You know what? That was just one of those moments.
Oh, I'll take it. All right, so looks like all the commanders going up to front. I'm about to have to prepare. We've got a ton of mass incoming. So I'm going to power stall myself.
So we do. Oh, my God. I've got so much mass. So much mass.
More. Give me more.
I will give you more. How do I give you more? Diplomacy?
No, just keep overflowing. Resources? That's fine. Just keep overflowing.
I'll give you more mass. Look, there you go.
already had 3/4 of a bar, but thank you.
Well, there you go. I'm a great guy. I know this, but I thought I would do it. Oh, what? Can I queue up a build order, please? There we go. Okay, that's fine.
There we go. Yup. Got a couple of factories down. Holy cow, you didn't even get any mass extractors.
No, I didn't. I literally did not. Did not at all.
Power.
I'm not going. I think I'm going tier 2 on 3 factories, which is probably a really dumb thing to do. But
well, I would be getting your mass extractors claimed and getting T2 mass extractors while you have all of this extra income.
That is a good point.
Because you're going to have 3 T2 factories and absolutely no mass to run them. So yeah.
Okay. The exercise in selfishness looks like it mostly paid off. Okay, I'm going to start retreating my commander. In fact, I'll retreat him this way. Okay, that's good. That's good. We're doing fine here. I'm fairly happy with the progress that I've made. I'm power stalling a little bit, but I'm not too worried, to be honest. I'm not too worried. And soon I'll have, like, loads of tier 2 factories anyway, so that's lovely. Okay. Oh, my.
All right. I didn't quite cycle these T2s.
Oh, apparently.
All right, suck up that mass right next to you.
We're gonna wreck this dude. Me and Purple, we're gonna tag team this dude.
I am off to such a terrible start here.
Oh,
brain.
This commander's going down.
So y'all are gonna score a kill right off the bat here.
Unless he walks into water, which he will.
No, you're not. Okay.
Yeah.
Well, that works.
A little bit of an issue there. Whatever. Just retreat back. It's not dithering about.
I gotta start thinking about some air here. Let's go ahead and get down. Alright, that was officially a terrible early build. I'm sure everyone watching this is currently screaming inside their heads.
Maybe they're doing more than screaming inside their heads. Maybe they're screaming outside their heads. You never know.
If you were screaming from outside your head, I think you might have a little bit bigger issues.
Well, if you're screaming from outside your head, isn't that just like normal screaming?
Well, like, from would imply origination, so.
Now we're talking like, I have no idea what we're talking like now. It's complicated.
I think we're really overthinking this.
I think we really are.
Okay. I need to be overthinking drops, because drops are where it's at in this game.
Yeah, you need to be our carry. You need to make sure that you literally carry us to victory. Please carry us to victory.
Well, I'm going to build a T2 transport. Hop on it.
With what? Like some engineers?
Your ACU. You need me to carry you.
Oh, no. Oh, okay. I meant in the more metaphorical sense of you need to pick us up, put us on your back, and take us places.
All right. I'm going to scout your opponents on the other side here. And let's get a couple engineers going on a build that way. Reclaim up there. Got all these mass extractors on the mesa. All right.
Beautiful.
Looking good. Let's go for a T2 air factory. Because that's a fun thing to have.
A tier 2 air factory. Wow, that's an early tier 2 air factory, isn't it?
6 minutes. No, not really.
Is it not? I thought air was more energy expensive. Is that what
it is? But I have an absolutely gargantuan amount of T1 power generators. Like I'm turning easily 400 mass or 400 power at the moment, which is plenty to get T2. I should be able to drop T2 to power generators and then resource allocation. So.
Oh, that's lovely.
Yeah, I'll have T3 air up in a jiffy.
Tier 3 air. Holy cow.
I'm actually doing it really, really slowly. You should have T3 air before 11 minutes on this map.
Oh, what? What? I've got, like, nothing. I've got, like, literally nothing.
All right. Let's see how we got this going here. Get my commander up near some build power, and I completely forgot that I loaded a transport up and did not even expand with it. You see you've got some mass extractors out there, right?
Yeah, I'm working on it. I'm moving my dudes right now.
Good dealio.
I'm pretty excited about this. I think it's going to be A-okay.
All right.
My ACU is still a little bit far away from home, but That's okay. I was... Okay, so there, they, the white player especially, looks like he's sort of going for a little bit of a turtle build. He's put up some point defense, and he could be protecting himself against our outrageously large army.
That is not entirely uncommon. Turtle's usually a good thing to do. I actually need to drop an engineer up here and grab that reclaim as well, because there is some up on top of the mesa. As you can see, Green is already doing it on his side.
Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah. How much mass do trees give me?
One mass, 10 power per tree.
Really?
They give you power, yes, they do.
That's kind of nice. Okay, I'm going to get some tier 2 engineers. Because, why the heck not? 10 tier 2 engineers. Tech 2 engineers, even. And maybe assault tanks? Are assault tanks any good?
Yes! They are the hover tanks, so they're weaker than their landlocked counterparts, but they do have the advantage of speed and the ability to travel over water. So it's basically what you need at that moment.
Sweet. I am down with that. And then I'm going to go for some anti-air. So I'd expect some air shenanigans coming up fairly soon, I think. Have they not got an air player, like a dedicated dude to...
They do, or they should anyway.
Uh-huh.
Whether or not he will actually go dedicated air is their problem, not mine.
you're totally right. It is their problem. Oh man, this game is actually going very, very well, even though I'm playing very, very badly. I think this sort of reinforces the whole, you know, best thing about being in a team is that nobody actually has to be good. You just collectively need to not suck. You know what I mean?
It is a strange thing. Actually, if you have a coordinated team, it is better, because then a coordinated sucky team is better than one really, really good player and a few average people that are not working together.
You know what? I can actually believe that. I actually can believe that. That makes total sense to me. Okay.
I can't even count the number of times I've seen a team entirely comprised of 1400s that is all in voice chat just absolutely grind the face off of a team of 1700 or 1800s. It's actually quite hysterical.
I can believe that, in all honesty. I can believe that. Alright, I'm going to try and do a sneaky little attack.
Alright, super belated resource allocation going down.
What the heck is that? Resource allocation.
That is an upgrade on your ACU that is really, really awesome.
I've never heard of half of this stuff.
On the center screen, there is one that has a power and mass symbol with plus sign. That is resource allocation, and that makes your ACU produce about 3,000 power and 16 mass.
God.
So, in an assassination game, I mean, we're literally talking about... until the end of the game, till you die, you're going to have that mass income. So there's no reason not to get it in a long-term game.
Yeah. Wow. That's like a tier 3 mass extractor.
Yeah.
Quite a lot.
It costs a little bit more than a T3 power generator. It makes more power than the T3 power generator does, and it makes mass. So,
sickeningly nice.
It is incredibly good.
All right.
But you always sacrifice something. Like,
yeah,
you're losing out on the ability to get one upgrade or another by going for resource allocation. Usually, like on my commander, it makes your commander a little bit easier to kill because you're not able to get the personal shield upgrade. By the way, these rocks out here are actually reclaimable.
Oh, engineer.
There's a buttload of mass out there to be had.
Out there? Oh my goodness. I'm interested in that.
Well, if you can get there before I get it all.
Oh, we're competing for this, are we?
I dropped an engineer out there.
I'm working on it. I'm going as soon as possible. It's so much to concentrate on, especially like on these bigger maps. There's just so much stuff to do.
Yup. It's definitely a transition. That's why I wanted to get you to try it. Because
so different.
Yeah.
so very, very different. But I really, I'm enjoying it, actually. I'm actually enjoying it a lot.
It's a little bit slower paced after the hectic beginning, and then it gives you a little bit more time to think about some of the bigger units, a little bit more macro scale, as opposed to, oh, I have to move this little tiny unit way over here right now or I'm going to die type thing.
Uh-huh. Yeah, exactly. Exactly. That's a really interesting way of looking at it. Yeah, because you can't just sit back and you've got to sort of take a wider look of things. You can't just
can't stay zoomed in.
Exactly. Okay, this dude's got a frigate. Jupiter's got a frigate.
I would definitely move navy.
Okay. Do you want me to engage the frigate? Would I be able to take it out?
If you have a couple of hover tanks, then you should. Yes. Oh yeah, absolutely. Yeah,
I've got four.
You'll destroy it.
Looks like he's got a lot of frigates.
Is he UEF?
I don't know. No, he's not. He's Aeon.
Okay. Well, then he actually does have a lot of frigates because he doesn't have jammer.
Oh, damn it. Well, I'm engaging.
All right, T3 air is up in force.
Oh, God. Oh, God. This is going to be a substandard engagement, I feel.
Yeah, all right, I would focus on upgrading your economy at the moment because you have zero T2 mass extractors.
Yeah.
So I would kind of just start scaling that up as much as you can.
Yeah. Okay, I am building a naval factory at the same time, which is probably...
They are both navy on that side. We got three navies in the water over there. Ouch, chihuahuas. That is not going to be good.
Do I want attack boats? Maybe attack boats will help? Attack submarines?
Yes, but you're not going to get them built before his navy kills your factory, so don't waste the mass.
You know what? Wishful thinking.
I would shut off all of those T2 factories that you have, and I would take those engineers in your base and queue up some mechs upgrades and start pouring those on as quick as I possibly could.
All
right. Be what I would be doing right now.
I'll work on that. Okay, I want to do upgrade, and then I want to pause the upgrade. Okay, and then I want to queue them up, and they'll just do it, and I'll just unpause it when they do it.
This is kind of the opposite outlook of from the small maps, because on the small maps, you're like, okay, if I upgrade too many mass extractors now, I'm not going to have enough tanks to counter what my opponent throws at me, whereas on a map this size, you're thinking, if I don't upgrade my mass extractors soon enough, my opponent is going to outstrip me in economy, and then later in the game, I'm going to run into major problems because I don't have enough mass.
Yeah, it's so totally completely different. Like,
yeah,
I didn't realize how different this whole thing was, but it really is.
Not really, really a is. Problem. We will get through it here.
I'm sure we will. I'm sure we will. But this navy, holy cow.
I'm about to dump navy in the water.
It's a lot of nonsense over there.
he is not going extremely heavy air, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to produce enough... Ooh, I need to pull my air back, because he is killing it all with cruisers. Derp. Yeah, and you need to get your commander out of there now, because he's going to start... getting navy on you. I would run over towards purple space.
Yeah, that's what I'm doing. Survive, but it's just annoying. Just annoying. What's somebody doing? Send these. Okay.
Yeah, send all the hover. It'll drive that back a little bit. Buy you some time.
I can do that.
Let's see. What am I doing here? Well, at least we got both of the expansions. Oh, crap. I totally forgot that I have these mass extractors back here.
Four assault tanks. Do my heavy tanks float on water as well?
No, they don't. Unfortunately, obsidians have treads, so that means they cannot.
Oh, that's annoying.
Yup.
Indeed, they do.
All right, so I am building some gunships so that I can run to your aid if you need it. I need to start getting some power online. I think I'm actually going to try for early nuke, because nukes can be incredibly useful on this map.
Nuke? Oh, okay. That sounds rather scummy.
And once I get 7 or 8 restorers up, I should be able to challenge that Navy no problemo.
That's a good shout. That's a good shout, although all of my assault tanks are basically dead. Although it looks like his Navy has been successfully chased off, which is kind of...
I would say it does not look like he has enough to actually stop your obsidians. So I would take your obsidians and I would ram them directly into Blue's base.
Right. You're the boss.
If he starts coming on too strong with the Navy over there... Well, actually, I'll drive him back. I have enough restorers now. So I'll get rid of the Navy for you, and then you can get those tanks up into his base.
I'm en route. Oh, my. Oh, my goodness. Tech 3 gunships. Oh, ladies and gentlemen, we're witnessing a spectacle here today. This is impressive.
Welcome to a whole new facet.
It's completely different. It's genuinely completely different.
See, this is one of the great things about playing with newer players is because we're all used to these units by now, and it's awesome, you know, remembering. It's like, oh, yeah, it was so cool the first time I saw one of those.
Yeah. I can believe that, actually, yeah. Oh, my goodness.
All right. Lost one of my gunships, but I think we'll still be fine, and here comes the air engagements. And runaway win. So we're safe in air, and we now have a bit of naval help.
It's got nice missile defense.
Alright, so keep those tanks rolling. Just place a move order on the other side of the base and run them through. And I'm going to actually go after his comm directly. We're going to try to get a kill right here.
Well, do you want me to focus on his comm as well?
Run past, because you don't want to lose all the tanks in his ACU explosion. So kind of run that way and try to get into Yellow's base.
Okay.
And just get away from the commander.
All right. Well, he's... Yeah, he's... Okay. Now, okay, I've pretty much lost all of my tanks, let's be fair. He's positioned it quite nicely. Oh, damn. Oh, damn. Run away.
That's
run away.
You'll save a few. Tanks. Just a few, but you will save some.
Well, you know what? A kill is worth infinitely more than tanks, isn't it? I mean, you know, let's not be daft here. You know, that's a good thing that we got him killed.
Yes. And, crap. He rammed a strap bomber around my back end here.
Well, that does not sound like fun. All right, you know what? I'm going to continue to push into this guy's base because it doesn't look like Yellow's got much.
He's got 2 strap bombers in my base, killing all of my build power. Oh. Get out.
Oh, that sounds like it's not very much fun, I'll be honest with you. Okay, we take out the tactical missile defense.
To be honest, he should have just gone after my commander.
with a couple of strap bombers, that sounds like the more valid thing to do. But, you know, perhaps...
I don't think he would have actually won it, but it would have been funny.
Perhaps since he's famous, perhaps since, you know, he's having his moment in the light being casted on YouTube, perhaps he's thinking, oh, it's okay, I'll just postpone from killing Brink for just a little while longer. you know, he might. You never know. People do crazy things to be internet famous, don't they?
Purposely losing a video game is probably not one of them.
You never can.
I wouldn't think, anyway.
Oh, this guy's going down. This guy's getting absolutely...
We're going to get a second kill here.
Well, you say we. I mean, this has been like...
Your tanks helped. Come on now. Let's be real.
A little bit. I mean, barely. I mean, oh, goodness sake.
I totally forgot I was going to build Navy in the back here.
All right. I think green, I guess. Green's probably going to be super undefended. Yeah, he's got some... What is that?
He's got some anti-air. I'm going to hit this P-Gen over here with what I got left, and then I'm going to shift back to ASF production.
Good shout. Okay.
That'll leave me a little bit in the back here to protect with. I'm gonna reassist these and get my build power flowing back in the right direction.
Oh my goodness. My economy is like literally trash. Like genuine hot garbage.
What's your mass income right now?
It's plus 22, right? That's not a problem.
Want to take a stab at what mine is at the moment?
What is it?
Well, let me wait till the reclaim dips down, so I don't have that. Okay, 217.
217.
Yes.
All right, no, mine is actually plus 39, so mine's slightly more impressive than I made it out to be. But two, what number?
217.
217.
Uh-huh.
That's horrific.
Which is pretty pretty typical on a map size like this. Around 20 minutes, you need to be busting 150 at least.
Oh well, it's okay. I'm pushing 40, so I'm.
You see White over there? He's also got T3 air, and he's got 3 T3 mass extractors already.
Oh my goodness, that's kind of crazy, actually. Can I just walk into Green's base?
No. Probably. You can walk anywhere on the map you want to. Whether or not you're going to live is the real question.
All right. I didn't ask for the smart ass response. All right. I just asked, can I do it?
But if I'm a smart ass, what am I supposed to do? Oh, good lord. He's pushing frigates around the back. Come on, Red. Get some Navy out. Ah, you have a T2 sub. Okay. I can be happy with that.
Okay, I've got pretty much.
All right. So let me build a nuke launcher because that's great fun.
A nuke launcher?
Yes.
That sounds epic. Like, literally epic. All right, let's go for that there.
If my engineers will ever get out of the way. There we go.
Hey, I'm glad it's all worked out for you, buddy.
All right. I need a shield over this for sure.
Absolutely wrecked. Can I get some air over here to take out his gunships?
I actually do not have enough air to save you at the moment.
Oh man. All right. Oh, you know what? It's okay. It's okay. It's not like I gave you that mask at the start of the game for a reason or anything. Jeez.
Oh yeah, I know. I'm actually going to zip out of here and get back so I don't lose the ASF that I do have. And we'll wait to engage in just a little bit after my numbers go up. Sorry.
Yeah, you know what? You know what? It's okay. I forgive you. I can only stay angry at you for so long.
Oh crap, okay. He's bombing out my mexes too. Why would you do such a thing?
Crazy people do crazy things.
I should probably also build nuke defense in case they have the same plan that I do.
Well, no, you see, this is actually my secret strategy. So what I'm doing is I'm playing really, really badly to try and, you know, get them to nuke somebody else, and then I'm just going to rush them with like a million units.
Oh, okay.
See, these are some next level FAF
this,
strats.
This could work. Maybe.
I think could is the optimal word here, and I think the likelihood of it actually working is almost nil.
All right, I got a couple of battleships on the left side. Hopefully that will be enough to deny this little bit of Navy here.
Okay.
Yeah, it will.
Heck, two destroyers, holy cow. And you've got battleships. Oh my god.
He better run. If he doesn't, I'm going to demolish this entire grouping here. Actually, it's too late. I'm going to anyway.
What do you think of the look of the battleship?
For the we need to help Purple. Push your tank south. Tanks south. El pronto. Roscoe's going to die.
I can't do anything about... he needs to build anti-air. What's he doing? Oh, okay. Alright.
Okay. Crap, he needs mobile flak is the problem.
Yeah, he needs anti-air. And he needs it like yesterday. Okay, I'm gonna build some. And I'm gonna build some flak as well.
Rud.
Hey, losing... Even if we lose one dude, it's not a major problem. These are just light tanks. These are not an issue. Where's his commander? Oh, damn it. Okay. Do you have any air?
We got two people producing air versus my one. Start making mobile flak from your factory so that we can push them into areas where we need them.
Sweet. I'm on it. I'll put two factories on mobile flak.
Good lord, that's a lot of spam. Tons and tons of T1 tanks. That's all right, okay. Roscoe saved his commander, so he's fine.
And I'll be able to clean up these dudes as well. tier 1 point defense. What is going on? Oh man, this game just goes from like exciting to excitinger. I have literally like no idea of what's going on.
Is exciting or a word?
It is now.
Okay. I'm just checking. Man. I mean, I didn't want to have to reference my dictionary in the middle of the game. Oh crap.
He's got What's going on?
I hit the stop button on my nuke instead of the freaking target button, which means that I stopped building a one-third way built nuke, which was really dumb.
Oh, amateur mistake.
That was really freaking amateur.
Oh goodness, I feel sorry for you, man. That must hurt.
That hurts me more than you know. My soul is in pain at the moment.
I'm gonna build some point defense so that this guy can come back behind them. I can't do anything about the AA gunships. I'm working on it, buddy. I'm working on it. I'm literally bringing the dudes to you as fast as I can. Oh, this is gonna be close. This is gonna be so ridiculously close.
Yeah, I'm gonna lose some ASF here, but
I'm not gonna be able to take out his gunships.
I'm gonna go ahead and. No!
Fudge.
Crap. Well, we had to lose one. That was the better one to lose because he does have the front and he doesn't have Navy.
Well, so. Yeah, but I would have been the best one to lose. Let's be frank about this. Like, I don't even know if I'm helping the team in any way. In fact, I would wager that I'm not helping the team in any way. Move quick, Potato. Oh, yeah. That's a good point, actually.
Yeah, you're out front where strat bombers can get at you.
Yeah, well, I suppose they can get anywhere, really, but... mobile missile anti-air. Yeah, let's build some tier 3 anti-air. Don't mind if I do. Mobile shield generators? Yeah, I'll build some mobile shield generators. Okay. I've got a butt ton of anti-air that's going to absolutely destroy any of his... units. Oh, there's a strat bomber. I see a strat bomber. There is a strat bomber. Here it is. Yep, strat bomber. Literally
right
there.
Your mobile flak will kill it. Just build a couple of shields over you.
Yeah, okay. Okay. Oh, goodness gracious. This is just...
Oh, man. All right, we got to win Navy or something.
Yeah, we got to win somehow. I mean,
cuz we can't maintain this for too much longer. All right, let's see here. I should be able to whip something up.
He literally destroyed all of my anti-air in one fell swoop. Holy cow, and he's going to destroy me right now. Well, no, he won't, actually.
That's fine, just keep plugging away.
Oh, God. One more shot on the commander. Oh, goodness, he's on 3,000 health.
You got to make a... it won't kill you in the next pass, but you got to make a shield. Make a mobile shield out of your factory.
Mobile shield? Mobile shield? Please, mobile shield. Oh, God. That hurt. That hurt. That hurts so badly. No.
No! Damn it. That was so close. I was making...
My mobile shield literally just finished as well.
That was such a terrible execution on that turn.
In fact, you know what?
I am the reason that you died, my friend. I am so terribly sorry.
No. Look at what I had. Look at what everybody else had. The reason that I died was my bad plays. That's what happened, right? There's no disputing that. It was my own incompetence that led us to this position. And alas, 'tis a shame.
All right.
It's a shame.
Let's see what we can get going here.
What's your plan? Tell me through your plan.
I am going to try not to die and try to kill everyone else. That is my plan. How I'm going to accomplish that is a different story entirely, which I do not know as of yet. All right, if I can plant a nuke in this, like, he does not have anti-nuke anywhere. So I can actually wipe out White's entire base with one nuke.
Freaking do it. That would be blooming awesome.
And I'm going to plant the nuke at the back and hope he flees in that direction so I can get the commander as well. Because that would be the icing on the cake.
You're so devious. I love it. I love it.
All right. Let's see. All right,
where's your nuke?
Right there.
Where?
Why didn't it ping?
Where? Right there. Oh, so it is your strategic missile launcher. Okay. That's cool.
Yes, sir.
Oh my goodness. When's it ready? I'm excited.
Oh, good lord, he has a czar. No! No!
Oh my goodness.
Stop!
Strategic launch.
We did not order donut delivery.
Oh, this is hilarious. This is
yes. Like, out of my sky, you freakishly overgrown pastry.
But all he needs to do is fly over Red's base, and it's going to destroy everything he has.
And here comes the strat bombers. No, don't die to the fall. Oh. Ah, the donut fell on his head, and it killed him with the fall damage.
This is the craziest of crazy games.
Crud. Since when has a czar killed anyone in an actual game? That's what I want to know. Apparently, this is when it happens. Ugh.
First time for everything.
All right. Well, I've got to come up with something to build because apparently I do not have enough mass being invested. So,
let's throw down some battleship
spam. Oh, score!
It's nice. 1v1.
Nice.
It's Brink versus Jupiter.
Okay. Well, I guess I should probably do something productive then. Okay.
Oh my goodness.
I'm spamming up power as fast as I can down here. That's my problem at the moment, is I just simply don't have enough power. All right.
Oh my goodness. I don't know what's coming. Do you have any information on the dude? I mean, I don't think he's got a very big navy. You could just, like, I don't know, go up behind him and just shell the...
That's actually what I'm doing right now, is building battleships.
Yeah.
To try to push over in that direction.
Strategic missile submarines. Wow.
Yes, sir.
That's pretty cool.
All right, I'm going to push these battleships up on the back side and see what happens. Let's see. I need lots and lots and lots of power.
Oh, look, somebody's apparently, if you reclaim the czar, unlimited power or something, I don't know. Maybe
He's being sarcastic.
Oh, okay.
It's not unlimited, but there is a hell of a lot of reclaim in that.
Yeah, I can't believe.
I can't remember right off the top of my head. 20-something thousand mass?
But it's a butt ton, and that's an official
name. It is a legitimate butt ton of mass.
That's good to know. That is really good to know. Okay, so he's got some cruisers and stuff. That's not too shabby.
He's got some stuff and things.
Stuff and things and stuff and things. Pretty much. Yeah.
All right.
Okay. Wow. It's going to take a long time for your battleships to get anywhere remotely near his.
Yeah. T3 Navy is slow. That is definitely one of the downsides. But it is very, very powerful once it gets there. So.
Are you building another nuke?
Does have that going for it. I am actually building 3 nukes at the moment and about to start the 4th.
Oh my god.
We are going to have a veritable nuke-a-palooza here.
A nuke-a-palooza. I believe the correct term is apocalypse. I think that's what you should probably use as one of these
strategic nuke subs, I believe, is named Apocalypse, but I'm not sure which one it is.
Really?
Which factions. Ah, crap! He's got his own battleships. Get back here. Get away! Run! No!
They don't have anti-air on them, though, do they?
No, they don't.
Well, maybe... Oh, no, he's got a cruiser behind that. Oh, man. This is intense! I don't mean the sort of camping variety. I mean the excitement variety. Ba-dum-dum.
Well, that means I should probably pull these battleships back to the homeland here.
Okay.
All right, cruiser is down. Let me do some...
Oh, battleships. Oh my god, you've got so many engineers. That's disgusting.
Well, when you have a huge mass income, you need a lot of build power.
That's a very good point. That's a very, very good point. So when are you going to nuke him? That's my question.
I need to get in the water so I do not die to something stupid. All right, let's see.
So, okay, if you were gonna estimate right now, how do you think that you're gonna kill him or he's gonna kill you?
Probably nukes. If I kill him, it's gonna be nukes. And then if he kills me, it is probably going to be something that I don't see coming because I am just not being very observant. So, okay. Yeah. Let's run okay. with that.
That's fair enough. I mean, is there not a possibility of a land army or something coming out? Is that not a possibility?
It is, yes, but he's going to have to project. Oh, holy crap. I'm glad you said that. I don't have radar.
Yeah, you've got like zero intelligence of what's going on, actually.
Terrible, terrible. Noob mistake. This is a noob game all the way around.
I think that's not entirely true. No. Yeah, there's that cruiser. Watch out for that cruiser in the air. Yeah. Well, at least you're going to get the battleship. He is probably going to wreck like all of your engineers, though, and probably your factory. Which is a little bit of a bummer, I suppose.
Yeah, but it's okay. We'll regain control.
Oh, okay. 84 more life on this battleship. 84 more life. That battleship right there. Kill him. Kill him. He's got 84 life. You need to kill him. You need to kill the battleship.
I'm retargeting. Zap.
Oh, thank goodness. Thank goodness.
Okay, we're good.
Okay. Oh, he's got... Oh, this is intense, man. This is really intense. Oh, my God. This swarm of air superiority fighters... Just to take out that one gunship. That's crazy. Okay. Your commander is in the water. Is that a tactical decision?
Yes, it is. That is a prevent them from teleport sniping me decision.
Mm-hmm. I like it. I like it a lot. Is it not a possibility? If I'm not wrong, is there a Tier 4 submarine sort of thing for Aeon?
There is a Tempest, the T4 battleship, but I am better off building normal battleships.
You sure?
I am 100% positive.
One engagement. You're fairly shredding him. It's going to probably be pretty even, though.
No, he's going to lose.
He is going to lose big time. How did you manage that?
Some slightly less awful micro than he had.
he committed a lot and he lost everything. It's embarrassing for him. And his battleships have failed to push further at all. I mean, like, all they've done is tried to take out that naval factory and failed hugely. So, I don't know, maybe his lack of concentration means that he's concentrating on something else. Genuinely. I don't know what it is, but...
Alright, he's got a missile ship, which is an interesting choice. the Torrent, the missile ship for the Aeon, it is the longest range main attack unit for Navy.
Uh-huh.
Has tremendous range. Inland. Let's see. I have a total of 3 nukes at the moment. So these scouts are going to see what's going on in the back here, and then we are going to decide where to pick our targets. But, cool thing, strategic subs actually do have normal, run-of-the-mill TAC launchers on board, which means that you can use the TAC launchers on the subs to kill nuke defense. Okay. And then proceed to nuke the target into oblivion without the fear of losing a nuke to the anti. So, I'm going to target these things up. We're going to get in range of the TAC missiles and try to take out that defense.
Did you see the Galactic Colossus that was building?
I did see the Galactic Colossus that was building, and I think I will be totally fine because I have a gargantuan swarm of gunships. So he is not going to get anywhere remotely near me unless I give him permission.
And the Quantum Gateway, you saw that pumping out like a butt ton of support commanders?
Yes. Again, not going to help him.
That's worrying, man.
I don't think so. I think we'll be fine.
So how many nukes are you going to be launching on his base?
I will have enough to drop 6 simultaneously by the time by the time that goes up. But let me see. I've got almost 2 loaded at home, actually.
Okay.
Let's go ahead and preemptively nuke the rear expansion.
If his commander's underwater, then he's in a lot of trouble. You know? He's in big time trouble.
Yeah. Alright, as soon as I get some of these nukes away,
strategic launch detected.
I need to launch my nuke before he finds my subs. And yeah, I think I can do that pretty dang easily. Let's see, we got scouts coming out.
His Tech 3 missile ship is heading up to detect your subs right now.
That means he's got it on sonar, but he doesn't know what it is yet.
Yeah.
So, yes, I am going to go ahead and launch, I think.
I don't know if he's just going to, like, do something really big that none of us expect. I mean, oh my goodness, look at the number of support commanders he's got. Like, 7 or 8. Okay, so that's going to go down there. Okay, it's going to take out a nice little expansion. Oh my god. This is horrible. Okay, so you're literally just going to absolutely destroy his base. Is that what you're sort of going for?
Detected.
You're evil. This is just... Look what he's saying in the chat. He's just saying, Poor guy.
Didn't expect this at all.
Poor guy.
Oh, this is awful. This is actually awful. I might feel a little bit bad about this.
Why?
He only had one nuke defense, poor guy. Oh no, he did have more than one. Oh, I didn't kill the original one. Okay. That makes more sense now. Oh, good lord, that's a lot of cruisers. Oh, crap. I think I have enough restorers to kill them all. Maybe, yes. Possibly.
Oh my goodness, that is a lot of cruisers.
Easy.
You'll be fine. Don't worry about it, man. Oh, no, in fact, look, there's loads of them. There's an absolute butt ton of cruisers. Butt ton is, of course, the official measurement for anything, really.
Yes, it is.
So where is his commander, then?
Where is my... Okay, I do have another loaded at home. Let's go ahead and plant another nuke on his base. Hopefully, he will...
Nope.
Good lord. So many cruisers.
Yeah.
All right, I'm going to back off of this. We're going to bring the battleships up. And hopefully, the battleships will be able to take care of it.
I wish I could see both this guy's base and this guy's face right now. Because it must just be like... twisted in anger and rage because this absolute douchebag launched 6 nukes at him. Like, what sort of a guy does that? Like, what sort of a human being does that?
This kind of human being, obviously. Oh! Tech 3 support commander teleporting in. Get the gunships on him right now. He's trying to kill the nuke launcher.
Where is he?
He's going to succeed at killing the nuke launcher.
Oh, man.
Right there. But the nuke is already on the way, so... Hold on.
What? How did he teleport in?
I guess he had another anti loaded. Oh well. Dang it.
Oh my goodness.
That means he won't have an anti for the other one. Okay, so that nuke is down.
I don't want to say evil human being is the correct term to describe you, but I think it's looking more and more like
I have told you on multiple occasions that I'm a troll player. You should know this by now. Like, legitimately, my ranking is definitely an average. Because either my troll solutions work really, really well, and I just nuke everyone into oblivion and kill everyone with massive amounts of hilarity, or my cheese fails horribly.
See, what would you define this as? I mean, this is clearly cheese, but has it failed or has it succeeded? Has it failed?
I'd say this cheese is probably on the verge of succeeding, but I am not going to call it yet because I could still die in a blinding flash of stupidity. So let's leave it at that.
Okay. I can appreciate that. Oh man, that's a big explosion.
There's another nuke. Did I kill the nuke defense? That's the question. I should have specifically targeted the nuke defense. But the nuke defense did die. Okay, so we're good on that one. We are good on the nuke defense. So I'm wrecking his navy. We have officially won the navy. So I will be able to keep my subs online. The Galactic Colossus is in the middle, but it will die before it makes it to my base because I have lots and lots of restorers. So lovely gunships.
Are you sure it's marching at a fair pace?
Yeah, it's gonna be dead.
I love your confidence. Just calm and collected. It's gonna do some damage though.
Oh, hello air.
Oh, that's. I think he probably should have pushed to kill your gunships.
Not more necessarily. He definitely shouldn't have stopped because he was behind my ASF the whole way. There we go. Successfully killed the entire clump. Okay.
Nice.
There's a small, very small amount left, but I think we're good.
And the Galactic Colossus is going down very, very soon. So what's his base looking like, actually? Like, is it... It must be.
I gotta get some scouts across. Give me just a second.
Yeah. I mean, All right. Must be gone.
Part of it is.
It must be gone. The Quantum Gateway is still
up and running. Where are the rest of my nukes? There, I got a nuke. Alright, so we need to drop a nuke directly on the Quantum Gateway so we can hopefully eliminate that nuke defense. Oh, he just called the GG.
Oh.
I don't blame him. If he didn't have one loaded, that was going to be the final nuke. I mean, exactly. He didn't have anything else to turn to, so...
Exactly.
Take the loss with dignity. 43 minutes. Holy crap. That went on longer than it should have.
Wow. So why did that go longer than it should have? Was it just because there was a constant back and forth in trading how well people were doing? I don't really know, to be honest.
Well, there are a couple points in that game where there were distinct advantages for one team or the other, and we just didn't focus enough on a solution. Like, I should have expanded better. I should have put more build power into one thing or another and not just, like, spread out and do whatever I feel like. If I would have been more focused, I would have killed more commanders early, and then I probably could have killed them quicker instead of leaning back on the long-term solution of nukes. And then theirs is actually, I can say the same thing, they did own air for a while. If they had just gone straight strat bombers, they probably could have killed me at that point. And if they would have killed me, there would be no air on the map, and then they could have killed everyone. So,
yeah.
Killing
you
off
were
the...
Like, you, sorry, no, you were like the spine that held this team together, man. You know, you're like you're like the bacon in a...
little too much credit.
In a bacon sandwich, you know what I mean?
It is kind of true if you own all the air. Because eliminate the air, then strat bombers kill everyone.
Exactly. So... You know, you were the bread and butter and the bacon, actually, of this team.
But killing off the front players is nice. But if you don't kill off the biggest eco and you don't kill off the support player, then that player is probably going to have the resources to pull a comeback. So that kind of needs to be your priority target unless someone else is in immediate danger to you. It's usually better to work out a solution to kill the guy who has the most developed economy because that's going to prevent a comeback.
Yeah. I just want to say, right? Like I'm going to claim that this victory was like almost like 60% reliant on me. I mean, you know that mask that I donated to you at the start of the game?
Yes.
That changed the battle from like losing to winning. Like that, oh man.
Strictly on that early reclaim, did you see I was like 30,000 points ahead of the other air player? So yes, you can totally take credit for that.
All me. 100%.
All right, well that was an awesome game. I think this is your first time with a larger map, isn't it, Potato?
I think it was fairly self-evident that was the case indeed. Yeah. Yes.
All right, so we've been warmed up. We're going to go play a second game, which again is going to be over on Potato's channel. So go ahead and hit the link in the description if you want to check that out. That's going to wrap it up for me, though, folks. So as always, thank you so much for watching. It has been a blast, Potato. Thanks for coming, man.
Oh, no, thanks for inviting me. I really appreciate it.
All right, guys, we will see you in the next one.